It's the National Football League on EA Sports, and we've got a show.
The veteran kicker, Dustin Hopkins, out to get things started. And off we go from Cleveland. Justice Hill to return. Good return, but he pays the price at the end. Picked up and thrown down. The Ravens led out by the reigning MVP of the National Football League, Lamar Jackson, already season 7. Greg, he's won a couple of MVPs, and he's as talented as we see in the league.
Is there a more exciting guy in the NFL to watch play quarterback than this guy, Mike? I mean, one of the most dynamic athletes to ever play the position. And what's truly unique about him is his ability to beat you both as a runner and equally as a passer. And that's really where his game has developed. Defensive coordinators, they don't sleep very much when they know they're facing this guy and all the problems that he presents.
Now the Ravens' big ticket free agent acquisition. It's Derrick Henry. And he'll manage to work this forward to the 37. That was Jordan Hicks who got him down.
Hey. Shut up.
On third down, Jackson. Nowhere to go. He's going to be taken down.
The best thing they did here, Mike, is keep their rush lane integrity. What that means is you have to rush the quarterback as a unit. Keep him in the pocket. Keep him on that X. And when you do, man, he becomes a sitting duck for this pass rush.
So the drive ends, and on comes Jordan Stout to kick it away. Nyheim Hines back deep for the Browns. This fielded inside the 35. And it'll be a good return. He's able to get it up past the 40-yard line. The Browns led out by their quarterback, Deshaun Watson. The stardom early in Houston. Now his third season with the Browns, eighth season in the league, as Watson tries to get this Browns team going in this one.
In my opinion, Mike, if they expect to leave here today with a win, they're going to have to be aggressive early and often. They might not connect on all of them, but pushing the ball downfield could open up a lot of opportunities for you to take advantage as this game unfolds.
And he got rid of that one quickly before the receiver knew what was going on. That's incomplete.
They just rushed that decision just a little bit downfield. I mean, it's one thing to trust your guy to make a play in tight coverage. We see quarterbacks do that all the time. But I think if he was a little bit more patient in his progression, there was an easier throw out there that wouldn't make him have to throw such a tight window ball and put his receiver in a tight spot.
Here's third and 7.
This is it.
Now it's Watson. And on third down, that ball incomplete.
They told us this week they were going to try to come out fast. And tell you what, that's exactly what they did. Put immediate pressure on this secondary and let them know, hey, all game long today, you better defend every blade of grass because we're coming out firing. And even though that ball falls incomplete, it goes a long way in setting up the rest of this game plan as the game unfolds.
And we will not see a return on this one, as it will be marked down. The Ravens' offense, ready now for their second drive. They'll search for the first points of this game as they begin the drive on first and 10. They'll start out on the ground with Henry. He'll take this forward for about a yard at best. Juan Thornhill up from his secondary spot to make the play.
Hey,
in motion comes Andrews. Second down, Jackson. And that's going to be incomplete. Coverage was good that time. The contact jarring the ball loose and forcing third down. They'll motion over Flowers. On play action, here's Jet. And this drive is over before it can start. It's swallowed up to force fourth down.
Outside of a turnover, this was probably the worst case scenario. Immediate pressure in his face with nowhere to go with the ball downfield. Just get the ball out of your hand. Live to play another down. Instead, he retreats backwards and leads to a massive loss.
Here's Jordan Stout now, as he'll hit this from just outside of his own goal line. This will be returned from the other side of midfield, and he's going to be brought down after a short return, and that's where his team will get possession of the football. They'll break the huddle, coming up now for first and 10.
They're set.
Here's Watson. It's a short throw caught by Njoku. And he's brought down after a gain of six on first down. They'll work now on second and four.
Set.
Now the Georgia Bulldogs. Here's Nick Chubb. And they'll move this one down inside the 40-yard line. A gain there of 10 yards. First down, Cleveland.
The goal of every offense, Mike, is to find a way to establish a balance between the run and the pass. With some success here early on the ground, will open up things as the game unfolds for the quarterback in this passing game.
And he's brought down after a gain of six on first down. On second down, here's Watson. He'll get that into the hands of Nick Chubb. And he will not get away. Terrific open field tackle. Gets him down behind the line.
To play corner in this league, Mike, you have to have great reactions and instincts. In this case, he trusts those instincts from the jump, and he's able to send the offense going backwards as a result.
That's caught. It's the tight end, Njoku. And they're going to be set up in the red. They've got it inside the 15. The Browns going to use the first of their timeouts here. That's catch three just on this drop. And it gets his team a first down.
Where's that?
To the air again. Watson. To the back of the end zone. He's got it. David Njoku, touchdown Browns. Greg, it's the quarterback's best friend, and you were that guy for a lot of years. The tight end in a tight area with man coverage.
Yeah, and it's really twofold, Mike, right? First and foremost, we see so many of these tight ends around the league that now have gotten to the point where one-on-one matchups, that's advantage offense. But then even in the cases they don't create great separation, Mike, it's their size, their catch radius. It's such a friendly target for the quarterback that when things get tight in the red zone, they look to the tight end.
Nothing is our score as this kick is sent into the air. Here comes Hill on the return. Oh, nice return, but he takes a big shot at the end of it. They'll come up here first and 10. A give right up the middle to Henry. And he's going to be stopped in his tracks. He'll lose a couple of yards on that one. So after one, it's the Browns with the advantage. And we're back to Cleveland in a minute. Here's a second and 12. The shotgun, here's Jackson. And he's not going to get away. They track him down.
This offense just continues to struggle to find any sort of rhythm. And now part of it is self-inflicted wounds. But the vast majority of their struggles has just been their inability to pass protect. You can't expect your quarterback to settle into the game and have any confidence operating out of the pocket when the second he hits his back foot, the play's over.
What can they do here? This is third and forever. From the gun, Jackson. And this drive is over before it can start. Swallowed up to force fourth down.
The defensive coaches, they preached all week, Mike. They have to have relentless pursuit of this quarterback when he tries to extend the play. So often, it results in a great play for the offense and a big pickup. This time, because of that pursuit, it leads to a big loss.
Jordan Stout out once again for the punt as he's standing right around his own goal line. This will be returned from just beyond midfield. And it's a good return here, able to take it across the 50. Set up the offense with a short field. The Browns offense and quarterback Deshaun Watson getting set for their next drive. They'll begin with great field position, a short field, in fact, as they start with a first down. Out of the gun, Watson. He's got his tight end down the field. That's Njoku. Following the completion, we'll get a stoppage here for an injured player. And as the medical staff looks him over, we'll step aside.
This is it.
On first down, it's Watson. That's for the former Bronco. It's Jerry Jeudy. And he will get into the end zone. Jerry Jeudy. Touchdown, Cleveland. On to add the extra point. He's got it. And the Browns move out on top, 14 to nothing. Both teams ready to go once more. As the kick's away. And we will not have a run back here. It's a touchback, and we'll come out to the 20-yard line. So here's the Baltimore offense getting set for their next drive. They're staring at a two-touchdown deficit, 14-0. The score, as the offense tries to regroup and get going with first and 10. In motion comes Andrews. First down throw for Jackson. Now a screen set up for Henry. And that keeps him ahead of schedule. That's a first down completion of 7 yards.
You see so many teams wait till third down to execute their screen game, but I like in this case the play caller changes things up. He uses the screen game on first down, which will have an effect on this pass rush going forward. How aggressive do they want to get after the quarterback? Because they got that screen play still in the back of their head.
This offensive line just has no answers right now. It's another sack. Oh, goodness. After the play, that's Lamar having some difficulties down there. As the athletic training staff looks at him, we'll step away for a moment. Third and long.
Here we go. Back.
Throwing now from the gun. And they will continue to go backwards. He's taken down for a sack.
So after surrendering their sixth sack of the game, I looked down on the sideline, Mike, and found their offensive line coach. He grabbed his headset, removed it, and he slammed it on the ground. And truthfully, I don't blame him. His unit has been getting worked up front all day in pass protection.
Oh, hello. He is stopped in his tracks on that one. They made sure that return was not going any farther. Brown's offense and Jerry Jeudy getting set for their next possession. They'll have a short field in front of them as they try to extend this lead out further.
Set.
Now, first down throw for Watson. That's into the hands of Jeudy on the right side.
I wouldn't be surprised if some point here in the future, Mike, this quarterback drops back. It looks like the same old hitch route underneath we've seen a few times. And they give a pump fake and go. You can lull a defense to sleep with a lot of these underneath quick game passes. And what you do, you try to go for the big one.
It'll be a pickup of 10. It's a Browns first down. 2 minutes remain here in this first half. We'll have more from Cleveland after this. So they come to the line for first down and 10.
We're set.
From the shotgun, here's Watson. And that one knocked away. It's incomplete.
Well, not exactly breaking news here, Mike. They got speed on the perimeter that just not a lot of teams in the NFL have. So even though that ball falls incomplete, I think they have to continue to do it, continue to pressure this defense and make them defend the entire field. Because as they're worried about him running by them, there is a lot of space open underneath.
At 24.
Watson to throw again. And it's complete to the sideline. Nice job getting both feet down inbounds.
This is why the timing of these routes is so critical. If that ball is thrown a little bit later, he's unable to keep his feet in bounds, but instead the quarterback is on time and accurate, and the receiver does a nice job not only securing the catch, but ensuring that both feet remain in bounds.
Amari Cooper was the man he was looking for, and it's going to be fourth down.
I like the idea of taking your shot there on third down, pushing the ball downfield, looking for the touchdown. But now as it brings up fourth down, you're already this close. You're in field goal range. But do you keep that offense on the field and try to maintain possession and see if you can come away with six?
A gain of 11 there as the decision to go for it pays off.
Set.
Throwing again is Watson. That'll be caught along the sideline. Good work there.
The best guys I've been around, Mike, they have a sense where they can see the ball, but they can feel the sideline. And that's kind of an innate sense that these guys have that allows them to concentrate and secure the catch and ensuring that both feet remain in bounds. They let a golden opportunity slip away on that one. That's the matchup that they wanted. They just couldn't quite capitalize on it.
Here's a third down and 4.
Reset.
Again, it's Watson. That's to the end zone, but it's incomplete.
You have to come down with those opportunities. You're not going to get your hands on the ball very often as a defensive player. And when you do, let alone in the end zone, those are plays you just have to make.
Hopkins' kick is good. And the Browns stake themselves to a 17-0 lead.
And this is what you want. I mean, you clearly have the advantage, but you want to continue to apply pressure. Can you score every time you get the ball? They're able to do that here. They tack on 3 and extend their lead.
The kickoff team is out on the field, and we're back to it as the kick's away. Hardy now with the return. And he'll be brought down past the 25. Decent field position to start this drive. The Ravens offense getting those helmets back on, ready to head out for their next possession. They trail this one 17-0 now. Really need to find some inspiration, some momentum on this drive as they'll begin here with first down. Now, faking the give. The pressure gets there, and down he goes back inside the 20-yard line.
Ready, ready.
Work to do now as they come up on second and long.
Ready.
Bateman is the motion man.
Ready.
Now they'll set up to throw. In trouble, and he's going to be taken down.
If this quarterback's offensive line had as much fight as he does, I don't think they'd be in this situation to begin with. I mean, it's not even halftime here, Mike, and they've already given up 6 sacks. At this rate, I'm not sure they're confident their quarterback's going to make it out of this game in one piece.
Zone read here on third down. That is not going to work at all. They'll manage to only get back to the line of scrimmage. Very short with first down. Fourth down coming up. Ravens bring their punt team out as he'll have to hit it from his own end zone. That's taken in at the 50. Oh, how about that hit? Wow. He took a pretty good lick at the end of that one.
Okay, Mike, thank you. More from you and Greg in a moment. But for now, welcome one and all to our EA Sports Halftime Report. We just watched a strong first half from quarterback Deshaun Watson. He fired his guys into the lead with 2 first half touchdown passes as they were looking like a well-oiled machine in the first half of play.
Very one-sided first half of action. Will we get a turnaround? Let's find out. The third quarter is underway. Oh, he's got room past the 30. Oh, very good field position to start as the return is past the 40. The Browns offense going to have the first crack at it as we begin this third quarter. The lead is 17 as they try to maybe pull away in this.
Set.
It is first and 10. This is brought in downfield by Judy. And he will go all the way. Jerry Judy. Touchdown Browns. That is 2nd touchdown of the afternoon. To tack on the extra point. The kick is good. And the Browns are able to extend out to a 24-0 lead. Both teams ready to go once more. As the kick's away. Hardy now with the return. And this will work out quite well. He'll get it all the way out to the 30-yard line. The Ravens offense makes their way back out to the field for their next possession. And look, they've been out of sorts throughout, Greg. They haven't had any answer for this pass rush all game.
Yeah, and it's really showing up in the sacks and also just in their ability to prevent any yards, any completions. This has just been a dominant pass defense performance here, and everything starts with the rush. The quarterback's uncomfortable. The clock gets sped up.
Under pressure, and he'll go down. They got him.
What I loved about this play, Mike, was the body language of the middle linebacker before the ball was snapped. We see so often they get antsy. They start tipping the blitz, and then the offensive line and the running back is able to pick them up. And in this case, it didn't look before the snap like he was going to come. He times it perfectly. Nobody accounted for him, and he records the sack.
This one complete to Bateman. And he'll be taken down all the way up past the 45. 23 yards on that pass play. First down, Baltimore.
Here we go.
On the handoff, it's Henry. And nothing on that one, back to the line of scrimmage, and that is it.
At this point in the game, Mike, we just haven't seen a lot of fire out of this offense. Here's another run, simple handoff, no game.
No motion over Flowers.
Ready.
On play action. Oh, they're on him in a flash, and he's lost the football. But this is taken in by a teammate.
So even though they avoid the turnover, this is still a play that they're going to coach hard off of. They're going to bring guys into the meeting room next week and say, hey, guys, we're not always going to be so fortunate. The ball is not always going to bounce our way. Anybody who handles the ball from the center to the quarterback to any...
That's over the middle and intercepted. Picked off by Greg Newsom. And his offense is going to be all set up with a short field and a chance to extend their lead.
I think anytime you find yourself trailing in the second half, Mike, all offensive play callers fight the urge to chase those points. They tend to get a little bit overeager. They tend to push the envelope sometimes a little too far. Those turnovers, they only make the deficit grow, not shrink. Now, there's a lot of football left, Mike. They can still get back into this. They just have to be a little bit smarter about which risks you're willing to take.
Here's first and 10. To throw is Watson. It is brought in the end zone. Touchdown, Cleveland. That is yet another touchdown pass. What a game he is having, throwing his fourth touchdown score of the game.
It's one thing, Mike, to throw four touchdowns, but it's really the ease in which he's carved his defense up that has stood out the most. The defense has had no answers for this passing game, and he has just completely had his way with this group.
Now Hopkins on to add the extra point. The kick is good. And the Browns move out even further ahead. It is now 31-0. The kickoff team is out on the field. And we're back to it as the kick's away. Hardy now with the return. And he'll work this one past the 25 to right about the 28-yard line. The Ravens offense ready to take over once again. They're in need of points in a big way as they set out on first and 10. It's the tight end Likely in motion. On first down, they'll start the drive with Henry. And good blocking up front, paving the way for a gain of 8 on the ground. We'll come to the line now on second and 2.
Let's go now.
Aguilar goes off in motion. Quick throw here is complete. And he's not going to be able to get away. Very good coverage on the perimeter. It goes down as a loss of yards.
Man, what a big tight play here by the corner. It feels like he knew that play was coming before the ball was even snapped. You can see he sticks his foot in the ground and bursts. He ends that play before it even has a chance to get started.
He'll try and get there on the ground.
You have to admire when quarterbacks are willing to put their head down and fight for some extra yardage, Mike. But sometimes the juice ain't worth the squeeze. Get down, protect yourself, live to play another snap.
Ravens sending the punt team out there as they are forced to kick for the 6th time today. That's fielded at about the 18. Ah, that could have broken for a bigger return, but as it is, Nice job getting his offense a start out past the 30-yard line. So out comes the Chicago offense as they get set to take over once more. They'll start on the ground with Chubb. And good blocking up front, paving the way for a gain of 8 on the ground.
It's a gain of 8. Brings up 2nd and 2 at the 42-yard line.
This is that.
Here's Watson now on 2nd down. Who else? Another catch for his favorite target. And he will score. David Njoku. Touchdown, Browns. 2 touchdowns for him now on the afternoon. What a luxury to have in an offense, a tight end who can take it down the field like that and take it the distance. Shades of Greg Olsen back in the day.
Well, I appreciate that, Mike, but I think it's clear by now that we all know what's the most impactful position on offense. It's the tight end. And when you have a guy like this who can not only make those difficult catches underneath, but who can get down the field for these big plays, man, you got yourselves a weapon.
Both teams ready to go once more as the kick's away. Hardy now with the return. And they'll bring him down just shy of the 30-yard line. The visitors' offense ready to come back out for this next possession. They'll start it here with a 1st and 10.
Here we go, set. Ready.
Right away, they'll set up to throw. Open man is Bateman. He's got him. And he's not going to get too far, tackled after a gain of just a yard.
Let's go. Bronco switch. Bronco, bring it.
They'll look to throw. That's to the right side. He's got Andrews. And he'll be brought down on what will be the final act here in this 3rd quarter. We're going to try to pick this up on 3rd and 8.
Ready!
Aguilar goes off in motion. On 3rd down, they'll set up to throw. And they will continue to go backwards. He's taken down for a second.
Defense came out in a soft zone. I think it caught the quarterback a little off guard. He was trying to attack them downfield. By the time he was able to get through his progression to his check down, he ran out of time, and that's all the pass rush needed to get to the backfield and bring him down.
Hunt team out, ready to send this one away. As the drive went in the wrong direction, he's on to punt it away. Now the return. Oh, hello. He is stopped in his tracks on that one. They made sure that return was not going any farther. Now it's the Browns' turn as they get set to take over again on offense. This one appears to be safe in hand. It has been a clinical performance to this point. Now they're trying to finish up strong. To throw on 2nd down is Watson. And that ball in and out of his hands. It is incomplete. Might tell you after the game he should have come up with that one. He doesn't. And now 3rd down comes up.
I think this defense is wondering where some of these missed throws were earlier in the game. I mean, for a while, it seemed like everything the offense did hit. And after that last incomplete pass, although this game's all but over, this defense will certainly take it.
And he looks to be a bit short of the line. And that is going to bring up fourth down.
We see teams more and more throw the ball short of the sticks on third down, really for two reasons. One, they're confident that they can pick up the first down with yards after the catch. Two, teams' willingness to go for it on fourth down is at an all-time high.
They'll try it now with Chubb. He's going to pick up the Browns' first down. Well, that was a tough couple of yards to pick up, but they convert on fourth and one.
Little test of wills up front, huh, Mike? I mean, who wanted this one more? Who would get off the line quicker? Who would drive the other side backwards? Pretty impressive that not only are they the ones that won the battle, the defense knew what was coming and still couldn't stop.
So 2 minutes left to play in the second half. We'll come back and finish this one off after this.
It's dead.
On second down, here's Watson. There's a short throw caught by Njoku. And he's got another one. David Njoku. Touchdown, Cleveland. He has come alive after the break. His third touchdown of the second half. So add another touchdown and touchdown pass for that matter. He has thrown six already in this one. Amazing stuff. Hopkins now to tack on the extra point. He's got it. And the Browns will add one more onto their big lead. The kickoff team is out on the field. And we're back to it as the kick's away. Oh, what an unforced error at an untimely moment.
Kick out of bounds.
Just tied the game, but then the kickoff out of bounds, and the ball comes out to the 40-yard line.
Automatic first down.
In motion comes Andrews. Jackson now to throw on first down. He'll try to hit him with a screen. And he's not going to get too far, tackled after a gain of just a yard.
Just a little slow developing on that screen play there. It was pretty obvious to the entire defense exactly what was going on. Nobody was thinking pass. Nobody was getting back into their drops. And just nowhere for that back to go.
And he's going to go down yet again. He has been under fire all game long.
I think the defense came in confident that they'd be able to get after the quarterback, right, Mike? When we met with them this week, they felt like they had a really good plan, some exotic looks, some different pressure packages, and it's worked to perfection. I'm not sure they thought they'd be one sack away from breaking the NFL record for the most sacks in a single game, but here we are.
Third and long for Jackson. And this offensive line just has no answers right now. It's another sack.
Mike, it is not very often where I am at a loss for words. You know that by working with me. But let's just set the stage. They just allowed a modern NFL record 13 sacks in one game. I mean, to say this is absurd would be a dramatic understatement, and I hate to say it, but performances like this, people lose their jobs over.
Another really nice throw right there. And as you can see the numbers he's been able to put up here, I'm a little surprised, if I'm being honest, Mike, with just how easy it seems to have been. It just seems like he's made every right decision every time that he's decided to throw the ball.
On the ground, it's Chubb to start this drive. And he'll manage to get this ahead for a pickup of 5.
This just shows why you can't count on just one guy to take him down. He's a powerful enough runner. You've got to have guys coming in support when that first hit is made. It takes a team effort to stop him, especially once he gets going.
Set up.
Back to throw is Watson. On throw, right side, taken by Njoku. And they'll take this down inside the 35. And that's going to do it. It'll put him over 200 receiving yards in the game. What a performance. That grab also comes with a first down. His way down inside the 30, a pickup of 6. So the Chalk Hound celebrates. It's a win for the Browns. And this was as good as it gets, all three phases of the game in perfect harmony.